Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real-world coding experience. And this is Han, the coding expert. If you want to pass the CPC exam, COC exam, CCS-P, or any outpatient coding exam to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding career, then you are in the right place. It has been 4 months since I started the CBC exam prep video series, and I have been receiving many positive emails and comments about how my videos are helping you, not only with your learning, but also giving you the confidence and some basic coding skill needed to tackle the CBC exam. In addition, the good news I received from those who just passed the CBC exam and all the exam is just fantastic and inspiring. I would like to thank them for sharing their good news and wish them all the best. For those of you who are waiting to take this exam, your turn will come. Just be patient. Continue watching my videos, taking notes, reading coding guidelines. Then I guarantee you, you will pass this exam as well. Slowly but surely, you are getting there. Today's topic is how to pass the CBC exam guarantee in 2020, Part 11, the Anesthesia Services, which is the topic that many of you are also waiting for me to go over. So without further ado, let's get started. Let's take a couple of minutes to go over the CBC exam sections in order to check our progress up to this point. So far, I have covered the integumentary system, the musculoskeletal system, the respiratory cardiovascular system, the digestive system, the urinary system, the nervous system, the evaluation and management, the radiology, the laboratory pathology, the medicines, the medical terminology, anatomy. On the medical terminology, anatomy, and physiology, I have received some requests that I should make separate video to cover this topic, so I just want to let you know that I'm still working on it. The IC10CM. The coding guidelines. If you watch all my videos, you should know the IC10CM coding guideline by now. Today's video, I will cover the Anesthesia Service section 00100,000 Service CPT. There will be a question about this section in the exam, so it's still crucial that you need to know how to code these services. Sometimes you just need either 1 or 2 points in order to pass the exam. So the more you know, the better chance you will pass the exam. On a side note, is it the same as radiology, lab and pathology section? Anesthesia services are coded to the Judge Description Master, CDM. In other words, hospital coders do not assign code for these services, except the consolidation or post-op pain management, but they are in the medicine section. That said, you need to know this for the exam, but in reality, you probably would not use these codes at all if you work in the hospital. Once in a while, I recommend that you should check back this slide to see the progress that you make and also find out what you need to catch up. As usual, what you need for my lessons are an IC10CM book, a CBT main notebook, notepad, highlighters, pens and pencil, and a quiet place that you can focus and study. And last but not least is your positive mental attitude, which is the most important element in addition to my tips and strategy that will help you to pass the CBC exam successfully. Also, just a friendly suggestion that if you have any question for me, when you type the question in the comment below, please give me a reference. For example, the case number or which minute of the video so that I know exactly what you refer to and I don't have to watch the entire video to search for your call. Thank you so much for your understanding. Type of anesthesia. The anesthesia session is a specialized session that is used by the anesthesiologist, anesthetist, or other physician to report the provision of anesthesia services, usually during surgery. Anesthesia means induction or administration of a drug to obtain partial or complete loss of sensation. Anesthesia, absence of pain, is achieved so that a patient may have surgery or procedure performed without pain. Types of anesthesia may be: general anesthesia is a state of unconsciousness that is accomplished by the use of a drug administered by inhalation or intravenously. Regional anesthesia is used to interrupt the sensory nerve conductivity in the region of the body and is produced by a few block or nerve block injection of the nerves close to the side. For example, peripheral nerve blocks, trigger point injection, nerve root injection. Epidural anesthesia is the injection of an anesthetic agent into the spaces between the vertebra, also known as peridural anesthesia, epidural block, spinal anesthesia, intraspinal anesthesia, and subarachnoid anesthesia. Local anesthesia is an anesthetic agent that is applied topically or by local infiltration. Topical anesthesia is used for minor procedures and may be used in the form of an ointment, gel, cream, or powder. For example, injecting lidocaine into the skin and subcutaneous tissue during repair of laceration or removal of lesion. Conscious sedation is a type of sedation that can be provided by a physician performing a procedure. It provides a decreased level of consciousness that does not put the patient completely to sleep. This level of consciousness allows the patient to breathe without assistance and to respond to stimulation and verbal command. The conscious sedation calls are in the medicine section of CPT 99151 to 99157. It induces an altered state of consciousness that minimizes pain and discomfort through the use of pain reliever and sedatives. It is administered in hospital outpatient facilities, for example, ambulatory surgery centers and doctor offices, to facilitate procedures such as breast biopsy, minor foot surgery, minor bone fracture repair, upper and lower endoscopy procedures. Conscious sedation codes are intended to be reported when the physician performing the surgical procedure is also administering the conscious sedation. If an anesthesiologist or other physician is administering the conscious sedation, then the appropriate codes from the anesthesia section 00100,000 should be reported. Physical status modifiers. These modifiers are used to indicate the patient condition at the time anesthesia was administered. The physical status modifier not only indicates the patient condition at the time of anesthesia, but also serves to identify the level of complexity of the services provided to the patient. For instance, the anesthesia service to a greatly ill patient is much more complex than the same type of service to a normal, healthy patient. The physical status modifier is not assigned by the coder, but is determined by the anesthesiologist and documented in the anesthesia record. Physical status modifiers are represented by the initial letter P, followed by a single digit from 1 to 6 as defined in the following list. P1 for a normal healthy patient, P2 for a patient with mild systemic disease. P3, for a patient with severe systemic disease. P4, for a patient with severe systemic disease that is a constant threat to life. P5, a moribund, in other words, a person at the point of death, who is not expected to survive without the operation. P6, a declared brain death patient whose organs are removed for donor purposes. Qualifying circumstances. Each of these codes is reported separately in addition to code for primary anesthesia. These services are add-on services and modify 51 is not required. 99100 anesthesia for a patient of extreme age, under 1 year or over 70 years. 99116 anesthesia complicated by utilization of the total body hypothermia. 99135 anesthesia complicated by utilization of controlled hypotension. And 99140 anesthesia complicated by emergency condition specified. Anesthesia guidelines. You have to know these guidelines very well in order to tackle case in the CBC or any outpatient coronary exam. So please take note. Time reporting. Anesthesia time begins when the anesthesiologist begins to prepare the patient for the induction of anesthesia in the operating room or in an equivalent area, and ends when the anesthesiologist is no longer in personal attendance, that is, when the patient may be safely placed under post-operative supervision. I'll give you a chance to apply this guideline in a couple minutes. Separate or multiple procedures. When multiple surgical procedures are performed during a single anesthetic administration, the anesthesia code representing the most complex procedure is reported. I read it again. When multiple surgical procedures are performed during a single anesthetic administration, the anesthesia code representing the most complex procedure is reported. The time reported is the combined total for all procedures. Safety modifiers that apply to anesthesia. Modify 23. Unusual anesthesia. Identify a procedure that usually requires local anesthesia or no anesthesia, but because of unusual circumstances, must be done under general anesthesia. Modify 47. Anesthesia by a surgeon. The modifier is not intended to be attached to the anesthesia code 00100-20199, but it should be attached to the appropriate surgery code. Additional modifiers that may apply to some services performed by an anesthesiologist are found in the Appendix A modifiers of the CPT book. You should check it out. Alright, I am ready to tackle question and case study. Are you? Let's do it. Question number 1. In an operative procedure scenario, the anesthesiologist spent 30 minutes prepping and administering the anesthesia to the patient. The surgeon spent 2 hours 50 minutes performing the procedure and then another hour and a half was spent after the patient was removed from the anesthesia and returned to post-op recovery. The anesthesiologist supervised the patient in post-op recovery for an additional 30 minutes. How much time should the anesthesiologist report for his service? I will give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer. A. 4 hours 45 minutes. B. 2 hours 50 minutes. C. 4 hours 50 minutes. Or D. 3 hours 45 minutes. Your time start now. Thank you. If you pick A, 4 hours, 45 minutes. Congratulations, that's it. You are doing fine. The anesthesiologist should report 4 hours and 45 minutes as the time performed for this service. According to the anesthesia coding guideline, the time reported should begin when the anesthesiologist begins prepping the patient for anesthesia services and ends when the anesthesiologist is no longer in attendance. Let's see how we come up with 4 hours and 45 minutes. In an operating procedure scenario, the anesthesiologist spent 30 minutes prepping, and then the surgeon spent 2 hours 50 minutes for the procedure, and then another hour and a half in this post-op recovery. And finally, in addition, the anesthesiologist supervise the patient in post-op recovery for an additional 30 minutes. 30 minutes plus 30 minutes is an hour, plus 2 hours here is 3 hours, and then 1 hour here is 4 hours, and then 50 minutes here plus 30 minutes here is 45 minutes. So the total time is 4 hours and 45 minutes. That said, the correct answer for this case is A, 4 hours and 45 minutes. Question number 2. Anesthesia that is administered by inhalation result in a complete loss of consciousness and affect the entire body is referred to as what type of anesthesia? I will give you 15 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer for this question. Your time starts now. If you pick C, general anesthesia, congratulations again. You are on the right track now. General anesthesia is deeply administered intravenously, result in a complete loss of consciousness and affect the entire body. Regional anesthesia only affects a specific body area, and local anesthesia affects a local body area. Epidural anesthesia is a type of local anesthesia that is injected directly into the space between the vertebra. That said, the correct answer for this question is C, general anesthesia. Alright, let's tackle case study. Case number 1. Before we start, please go get your CPT book and tap this section first, so that at least you know where to find these anesthesia codes. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 00211, 00210, 00220, and 00215. So all you have to do now is open your CPT book and look them up and find out what they are. Please pause the video and do it now. I'll wait for you. Assuming you already did that, and here's what you find. 00210, anesthesia for intracranial procedures not otherwise specified. 00211, anesthesia for craniotomy or craniectomy for evacuation of hematoma. 00215, anesthesia for cranioplasty or elevation of depressed skull fracture, extradural. And 00220, anesthesia for cerebral spinal fluid shunting procedure. Follow my tip and strategy. You highlight the key difference between each CPT code, and after you've done that, you should have an idea what your focus would be when you read the procedure report. The physician inserted a ventricular peritoneal shunt for the purpose of draining a cerebrospinal fluid shunt in a 9-year-old female patient with secondary hydrocephalus resulting from bacterial meningitis. what would be the correct CPT code for the anesthesia? You already highlighted the key difference between each CPT code and also the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick C, congratulations, good for you. The procedure performed is a cerebral spinal fluid shunting procedure. So 00220, anesthesia for cerebral spinal fluid shunting procedure is the correct code to report for the anesthesia services. That said, the correct answer for this case is C, 00220. Let's tackle the next case. Case number 2. Follow my tip and strategy. A and C have the same code, 00910, so they are in the same group. B and D have different codes, 00912 and 00400, so they are in different groups. Now you know there are three codes that you need to look up in your CPT book, 00910. 00912 and 00400. So please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CPT book and hear what you got. 00910, anesthesia for transurethral procedure, including urethral cystoscopy, not otherwise specified. 00912, this is an identical, so it includes all information from the code above 00910, which is the parent code, except it's for transurethral resection of bladder tumors. 00400, anesthesia for procedure on the integumentary system on the extremities, anterior trunk, and perineum, not otherwise specified. Follow my tip and strategy. You highlight the key difference between each vehicle, and after you're done highlighting, you should have an idea what your focus would be when you read the procedure report. The correct CPT code for anesthesia for a patient having a cystoscopy for fulguration of a bladder tumor and biopsy with cystoscope being inserted to the urethra into the bladder is. You already know the difference between each CPT code and also highlighted the key element in the procedure report. I will give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick B, 00912, congratulations, I know you can do it. Anesthesia code are selected based on anatomical site of the surgery performed. If you remember the anesthesia coding guidelines, when more than one procedure are performed, for instance in this case, the fulguration and the biopsy of the bladder are both performed, the anesthesia code for the most intensive procedure is reported, which is the transurethral fulguration or resection of bladder tumor. As I said, 00912 is an identical, so in the code description, it also includes the cystoscopy or ureteral cystoscopy with ED endoscopic approach. That said, the correct answer for this case is B, 00912. Let's move on to the next case. Follow my tip and strategy, C and D have the same code, 00960, so they are in the same group. I has a different code, 01961, so it in a separate group. B has 62320, which does not apply, because an anesthesia code stuck with 00100, so we can eliminate it. Now you know, there are two codes that you need to look up, 01961 and 01960. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming that you already did, and here what you find. 01960, an anesthesia for vaginal delivery only. 01961, an anesthesia for C-section delivery only. Basically, the main difference between these two codes are 01960 is for vaginal delivery and 01961 is for C-section delivery. So let's read the report and find out. The patient, a 30-year-old female with well-controlled type 1 diabetes mellitus, received an anesthesia for a regular vaginal delivery with no complication. Code for the anesthesia services only. You already know the key difference between each typical, and you may need to take another step to look up the physical standard modifier P3 and P2 here, since they all have modifier. So I will give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer for this case. Your time start now. If you pick D, congratulations, I know you can do it. First of all, this patient had vaginal delivery, so the correct code for the anesthesia service is 01960. From here, we can eliminate 01961. Anesthesia for cessation, which does not apply. C and D still remain, and the difference between these two answers are the physical standard modifier, P2 and P3. So please pause the video and look them up now. Assuming you already looked them up and hear what you see. Modify P2 for a patient with mild systemic disease, and modify P3 for a patient with severe systemic disease. Based on the report, the patient type 1 diabetes is well controlled, and the patient has a regular vaginal delivery with no complication. So the physical started modified P2 for a patient with mild systemic disease is appropriate to you. If the patient type 1 diabetes is uncontrolled and cause complication during the procedure, then modified P3 for a patient with severe systemic disease should be assigned instead. That said, the correct answer for this case is D, 01960 would modify P2. Just a friendly reminder that if you have enjoyed what you have learned so far and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe and share buttons below to support my channel. That would be great. You are the reason why I continue working hard on these videos. It's a very time consuming. I have to find case study first. Next, make the PowerPoint slide and then record a video. It takes the whole day to finish this, so I don't think it is too much to ask for your support. Thank you kindly, and we should move on to the next case. Let's bring it on. Case number 4. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 01400, 01380, 01214, and 01215. So all you have to do now is open your CPT book and look them up. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did, look up this code and hear what you find. 01400, anesthesia for open or surgical arthroscopic procedures on knee joint, not otherwise specified. 01380, anesthesia for all closed procedure on knee joints. Because 01214 is an identical, so I have to list its pairing code for your reference. 01210, anesthesia for open procedure involving hip joint, not otherwise specified. 01214, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the cover ball, 01210, which is the pairing code, except it is for open procedure, total hip arthroplasty. 01215, this is also an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above, 01210, which is the pairing code, except it is for open procedure, revision of total hip arthroplasty. Follow my tip and strategy. You highlight the key difference between each CPT code, and after you've done this, you should have an idea what your focus would be when you read the procedure report. Let's find out. A physician performed a total hip arthroplasty and an excision of a patellar bone spur, calls for the anesthesia services only. You already highlighted the main difference between each vehicle and also the key element in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick 01214, congratulations, you are the expert now. If you remember the anesthesia coding guidelines, when multiple surgical procedures are performed during a single anesthetic administration, the anesthesia code representing the most complex procedure in report. In this case, the hip arthroplasty is the most complex procedure compared to the excision of a patellar bone spur. So, 01214, anesthesia for open procedure, total hip arthroplasty is the only code that should be reported. In simple terms, it doesn't matter how many procedures you perform in the same session, you could only build one anesthesia code for the most complex procedure. Having said that, the correct answer for this case is C, 01214. I hope that you follow me okay. Let's move on to next case. Case number 5. Follow my tip and strategy. A and B have the same code, 01951, so they are in the same group. C and D have the same code, 01952, so they are in a separate group. Now you know there are two codes that you need to look up, 01951 and 01952. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did that, and here's what you got. 01951, anesthesia for second and third degree burn excision or debridement less than 4%. 01952, this is an identical, so it includes all information from the cover ball, 01951, which is the pairing code, except it is for burn between 4-9% of total body surface area. After knowing the difference between each two codes, now is the time for you to read the procedure report and find out. Let's read it. A physician performed burn debridement on a 50-year-old male who sustained 33 burns over 15% of his body. While burning dead brush in his backyard, what could be the correct cause or code for this anesthesia service? You already know the difference between each typical and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the right answer for this case. Your time starts now. If you pick 01952, congratulations, it's great. Based on the procedure report, the patient sustained a 33 burns over 15%, and 01951 is only for second and third degree burn less than 4%, so it doesn't apply. From here, we can eliminate A and B. C and D still remain, and the difference between these two answers is 01953. And 01953 times 2 units, so please pause the video and look up this code now. Assuming you already did that, and here what you got. 01953 is an add-on code for each additional 9% to total body surface. The code that we picked, 01952, which account for the first 9% area only. So we need to use the add-on code 01953, just one unit, which is enough to cover the remaining 6% for a total of 15%. That said, the correct answer for this case is C, 01952 and 01953. I hope that you are getting better and better and sharper each time you watch and learn from my videos. And all I'm asking is you're liking and sharing my videos to show support to my channel. Please pause the video and do it now before I tackle the last case. I really appreciate it. This case is very short, so I will read it first and then I will give you 30 seconds to figure it out. A physician harvested a viable left cornea, liver, and heart from a declared brain death patient. What anesthesia services should have been reported? I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me what would be the correct answer of this case. Your time start now. If you pick D, congratulations, I think you got it now. First of all, the anesthesia code starts with 00100, so right off the bat, you can eliminate C. A, B, and D still remain, and the difference between these answers are A has 01990, D also had 01990, but with modified P6 attached. B state that no code is needed, so please pause the video and look up this code 01990 and modify P6 to find out what they are. Please pause the video and do it now. Assuming you already did, and here what you got. 01990, physiological support for habiting of organ from brain death patient, and modify P6, I declare brain death patient whose organ are removed for donor purposes. The correct code to report for the anesthesia service is 01990, and modified P6 also needed to be used to indicate that the patient's physical status, which in this case is a declared brain dead patient whose organ will be removed for donor purposes. When an anesthesia service is performed, then the code needed to be assigned. Otherwise, the anesthesiologist does not get paid for his or her services. You might wonder why an anesthesiologist would be needed for organ donation by a declared brain dead patient. His or her job is to keep a patient's organs well perfused and well oxygenated. It means that keeping the patient's heart and lung function stable so that the donated organs can continue to give life in another or several others. That said, the correct answer for this case is D. 01990 with modified B-sheet attack. That is all for today. Thank you so much for watching, for liking and sharing this video. If you find this video helpful, informative and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great weekend.